गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर द जोडीज फॉन फ्रॉम द बुक हनी ड्यू। सो जस्ट टू गिव अ इंट्रोडक्शन टू द स्टोरी, इन द स्टोरी जोडी इज द बॉय, फादर हैज बीन बिटन बाय अ रैटल स्नेक। रैटल स्नेक इज अ काइंड ऑफ स्नेक विच मेक्स अ रैटलिंग साउंड और अ जिंगलिंग साउंड बाय इट्स टेल। It moves its tail in such a way that it makes a sound. That is why it is called a rattlesnake. He quickly kills a doe and uses its heart and liver to draw out the poison. And what happens is, Jodi's father has been bitten by the snake, which is poisonous, and they kill a doe and use the organs, that is heart and liver, to draw out the poison. The poison which is inside the that Jodi's father, that is Penny's body. Jodi wonders what will happen to the little fawn left without a mother. And now Jodi, the son, is wondering what will happen to the fawn. Fawn is a baby deer, is called a fawn. Like a baby cat is called kitten, a baby dog is called a puppy. Similarly, a baby deer is called a fawn. So he is thinking about what will happen to the fawn because the mother had been killed. Jodi allows his thought to drift, move back. Drift is move back to the fawn. Now he is thinking about the fawn. He could not keep it out of his mind. Now he is thinking about the fawn. What will happen to the fawn? The mother had been killed. In his dreams, in his arms. And he is thinking even in his dreams about the fawn. So he got down from the table and went to his father's bedside. So his father is lying down. As you can see in the picture, because he had been bitten by the snake and he was cured by killing the doe and using its heart and liver to draw out the poison. Penny lay at rest. Penny is his father. His eyes were open and clear, but the pupils were still dark and dilated. Pupils is the small holes, that is the front part of our eyelid. Not eyelid, in front of our eyes, the black hole from where the light enters our eyes and we are able to see. They were dilated, expanded. Jodi said, now he is having a talk with his father. How are you feeling, Pa? Just fine, son. Old death has gone thieving elsewhere. What he is saying, that I have a, but it was, wasn't it a close shave? Close shave means that it was a narrow escape. He almost died, but it was because of the doe that he is not dead, because they had used the doe's heart and liver to draw out the poison, to neutralize the poison. So he's saying, it was very close. I had almost died, but death has gone somewhere else. Thieving means robbing, chori karna. So he said, death kahin aur chale gayi hai. I agree. So they are having a talk, son and father. Penny said, I am proud of you, boy, the way you kept your head and did what was needed. And he's saying, I am very proud of you, the way you kept your head means your head was balanced and you were thinking properly and you did not panic or you did not worry. So they are having a talk. Pa, yes, son. Pa is papa, father, yes, son. Pai, do you recollect the doe and the fawn? Tumhe yaad hai? Do you recollect the doe and the fawn? I can never forget them. The poor doe saved me. That's certain. So he's saying it is because of the doe that I am alive. But Pa, the fawn may be out there yet. Now he's telling it because in his thoughts, he's worried about the fawn, the baby deer. It might be hungry and very scared. I suppose so. So his father is saying, I think so. I am a big boy now and don't need to drink milk. Why don't I go and see if I can find the fawn? So now he is taking permission from his father that he wants to go out and find the fawn. And why he is saying I don't need to drink milk? He is saying that if I find the fawn, I will give my part of the milk which I drink, I will give it to the fawn and bring it here and raise it. Penny lay quiet, staring at the ceiling. His father is quiet now. But you have got me hemmed in. Hemmed in means a situation where you cannot say no. So now he is talking to his father and he is asking for a permission. And hemmed means he's caught in a situation where he cannot say no to his son. It won't take much to raise it. He's saying, Pa, it will not take much to raise it. It will soon start eating leaves and acorns. Acorns are small fruits of the tree oak. जिसे हम हिंदी में बांझ के पेड़ बोलते हैं तो उसका जो फ्रूट होता है दैट इज कॉल्ड अकॉर्न्स. सो फादर सेइंग यू आर स्मार्टर बॉय देन बॉयज ऑफ योर एज. वी टुक इट्स मदर एंड इट वाजंट टू ब्लेम. वी किल्ड द मदर एंड इट इज नॉट. व्हाई शुड द फॉन सफर? व्हाई शुड वी लीव द फॉन इन द जंगल? वी किल्ड इट्स मदर टू सेव आवर सेल्फ. सो व्हाट इज द मिस्टेक ऑफ द फॉन? Surely it seems ungrateful to leave it to, ungrateful means selfish, to leave it to starve. Starve is without food. So how can we leave the fawn without food? Because, excuse me, the fawn doesn't have any mother now because the mother has been killed. Son, I can't say no to you. I never thought I'd live to see another day. So he's saying that I am saved because of the doe. Can I ride back with Millwheel? Millwheel is another character in this story. Ride back is on a horse. Can I go back to the jungle and see if I can find it? Tell your ma, I said, you can go. So he's saying, I have given you permission, now you can ask your mother. He sidled, that is, moved back quietly to the table and sat down. His mother was pouring coffee for everyone. And there his mother was giving coffee. He says to his ma, Ma, Pa says I can go bring back the fawn. So he's saying, Mother, Pa has given me the permission to bring back the fawn. She held the coffee pot in midair. She is serving coffee to everybody. And then when Jodi asks for permission, she's surprised. What fawn? The fawn belonging to the doe we killed. So he's reminding his mother, Wahi fawn, jiski mother ko humne mara hai. We use the doe's liver to draw out the poison and save Pa. It is because of the mother that Pa is saved. She gasped. Gasp is when you need to take a deep breath. That is called gasping. Because she is shocked that my son wants to go to the jungle. Well, for pity's sake. So he's saying Pa says it would be ungrateful. Ungrateful is selfish. To leave it to starve. How can we leave it to starve? Starve is being without food. Dr. Wilson said, that's right, ma'am. Nothing in the world comes quite free. The boy is right and his daddy is right. So even the doctor who has come to treat his father says that this boy is right. We should take care of the fawn. Nothing comes free. If we have killed the mother, we should take care of the fawn. So Millwheel is a person who says, he can ride back with me. Ride is on a horse. I'll help him find it. She set down the pot helplessly. So now she has to agree. Well, if you will give it your milk, we have got nothing else to feed. So the mother says, yes, you can go, but you'll have to give your part of milk. What you drink, now you should give it to the fawn if you bring it back. Millwheel said, come on, boy, we have got to get riding. And they start, as you can see in the picture, he's sitting behind Millwheel and they are moving into the forest and trying to find the fawn. Ma Baxter, Baxter is the mother of his mother, mother name is Baxter, asks anxiously. Anxiously is worriedly. You'll not be gone long. You'll not be late. Gone long means you'll not be late. Jodi said, I'll be back before dinner for sure. I'll be back, mother, before dinner. Millwheel mounted his horse. We never say I climbed the horse. Whenever you climb the back of a animal, you call it mounted. So Millwheel mounted his horse and pulled Jodi up behind him. So you can see Jodi sitting behind Millwheel. He said to Millwheel, do you think the fawn's still there? Will you help me find him? So now he's talking to Millwheel. Kya hame milega? We'll find him if he's alive. How you know it is a he? So he's saying, we'll find him if he's alive. He. So he's saying, how do you know it's he? He means male. The spots were all in a line. So that is the difference. If the spots on the skin or on the coat of the deer are in line, that means it's a male deer. On a female, the spots are everywhere, which way? And they are not in a organized way. So the difference between a he and a she baby deer is that in a male, the spots are in a line. And in a female, they are not in a proper line. So that was the first part of the story, Jodi's fawn. We'll continue the second part in my second video. Thank you all of you, and have a nice day. Goodbye.